Hello everyone, welcome back. This is Ramya Sri. I am going to deal the subject of programming in C for degree first year BCom and BSc. Today our topic is structure of C programming. While going to the structure of C programming, we are discuss on the introduction of C language. Before the C language, several other programming languages were developed. For example, in 1967, Martin Richards developed a language called BCPL, that means Basic Combined Programming Language. In 1970, Ken Thompson developed a language called B. By using many features, BCPL and B were typeless languages, that means had no concept of data types. Finally, in 1972, Dennis Ritchie developed a C language called C at Bell Laboratories, USA. C uses many concepts from the BCPL and B languages and added the concept of data types and other powerful features. So, some of the key features are behind the C language, that is portability, syntax based, case sensitive, structure oriented, middle level, uses of pointer, platform dependent, compile based, modularity, fast and efficient, powerful and simple. That means C programming is very simple and easy to understand. It was very portable to everyone, and it having some syntax based programming, and case sensitive is having, and the memory management is easily catched, and this is the structured programming language. It have some pointer types of programming and very fast to write programs and easy to write the programs, and recursion is possible by using the C language. So many advantages and features are available while using the C language. Variety of data types and powerful operators are also available in the C language. It is easy to extend the program in one form to another form. Modular design is very easily in the C by using the C language. And moreover, the functions and their libraries are very rich in C language. So these are the different features are available in the C language. Then we can go for the structure of a C program. Here, the structure of a C program can contain different sections. Those are documentation session, link session, global declaration session, and functional declaration session parts. So these are the different sessions while having the are mentioned in the structure of a C program. While going to the documentation session, it consists of comment lines giving the name of the program and other name and other details. In the link session, it provides the instructions to the compiler to link functions from the system library. Then the global declaration session having some of the variables that are used in more than one function. Such variables are declared in global declaration session, that is outside of all functions. So in the main session, every C program must have one main function. The execution of the C begins at this function only. This session contains two parts, namely declaration part and executable part. In the declaration part, we can declare all the variables used in the executable part. The executable part contains the statements that perform a specific work. All statements in the declaration part and executable part must end with a semicolon. These two parts must enclosed opening and closing braces. So the subfunction area can contain many number of user defined functions. These functions are called main function and all other functions. Then we can go for the compiling and execution of programs. Executing the C program involves three steps. Those are creating a program, compiling the program, and executing the program. While going to the creating a program, we can create a program by using the text editor. Here we can write the program by using the C code. This is the example for the C program, and after creating the program we have to save it on hard disk, and to save the program press F2 or file, go for the file menu and click the save option. Type the file name with extension .c. This is called a source file. Then after saving the program we can compile and execute a program. The procedure for compiling is, computer can only understand machine language. To convert source file into machine language, we need to convert it. To compile the C program, press Alt key and hold the F9 button. If there is no error, then the compiler converts the source code into machine code. If they have any errors, the errors will be displayed. Then the executing a program having the procedure is, to run the C program press Control plus F9, hold the Control button and press the F9 button. Now the compiler looks the main function in the program and begins execution from there. After compiling the execution, the program displays some of the output what the printf statement could have. Then we can use some comments in the program. Those comment statements are the program to make the code understandable by the programmer. Comments are put at the top or anywhere in the program. Comment lines are not executable statements and they are ignored by the compiler. C supports two types of comments here. Those are double slashes is used to comment in single line. This is also called a line comment. A line comment can be placed anywhere in the program and it does not require ending symbol. Then the second type is slash star, is used to comment multiple lines. This is also called as block comment. A slash star is ended with a star slash, and all lines between these characters are commented. So these are the different ways we can make the comments in a program. Thank you so much for watching.